Hello everyone. The intention of this series is for beginners. Whether you've never played Airport CEO at all, or you've played it for a little while and got stuck on something, or just plain got confused. That's the audience I'm looking for in this particular series. Now, I've started the game, and this is the interface you're introduced to first. Now, you could just jump straight in and begin a new airport, but just before we do that, I want to point out a couple of the gameplay settings that you need to be aware of. Firstly, it's the duration, or rather the interval of how frequently the game auto-saves. If memory serves, it starts on 5 minutes, and that's actually really short. You'll notice the game pauses every time it auto-saves, and having that happen every 5 minutes gets quite frustrating. I recommend pushing it out to 15 or 20. I wouldn't want to go too much further because there are some concerning problems with the game. It can crash every now and then. You don't want to lose your progress. You have the option of switching between metric, imperial, or metric, or imperial measurements. You can choose your currency sign. I'm going to just stick with the dollar. Clock. You can obviously have 24-hour clock or 12-hour clock with AM or PM. I prefer 24-hour clock. Normal time when incidents occur. Now, throughout the game, you'll have many emergency-type situations, like a plane hits a bird when it's trying to land, or maybe there's a problem with the engine when it's sitting on its stand and people have inspected the plane before takeoff. Whenever one of those events happens, having this selected means that the game will switch down to normal play speed rather than fast or super fast speed. I also recommend having pause game on start selected. That's perhaps more of a factor for people like myself who are doing video recordings, but having the game load, which takes a while, and then be playing as soon as it finishes loading can be a little bit of a trap. Depending on how fast or slow your computer might be, you might be inclined to say, alright, I'll load my save game, and while I'm doing that, I'll go and get a cup of tea. And then you come back and the game's already running. So yeah, pause game on start is a recommended option. It's not a big deal. Passenger per flight ratio. Okay, so it's about how realistic the game is. I'm actually going to bump that up to 100%. I wouldn't necessarily recommend it for a beginner, but yeah, this is meant to be more of an advanced tutorial. It's taking you from the absolute beginning steps, but taking you up to a high skill level. Alternative dragging method and most of these other options you can just ignore. The seasonal Easter eggs is things like Santa hats on planes during the end of December. But realistic international stands and Shenzhen visa rules are things you need to know about. I've got realistic international stands selected, but that's a personal preference. By default, when you install the game, it's switched off, and that means, planes come in three sizes. They come in small, medium, or large. With that switched off, large planes are always international. And only ever international. Medium and small planes are never international. With it switched on, you actually get a choice. Every time you put out a stand for planes to stop at, you get to say, this is for international flights or this is not for international flights. And the Shenzhen visa rules are applicable to the European Union. If that's switched on, which it is by default, any country in Europe, be it France, Germany, Belgium, what have you, they're all treated as one country. So the entire Europe Union is a single country and all flights within it are domestic. If you switch that off, a flight from France to Germany becomes international. It's not a huge factor if you've also got realistic international stands switched off. But if you've got international stands on and you're playing in Europe or near Europe, then this becomes a factor because it will determine how many international or domestic flights are actually available. And that's a point I'm going to touch on again shortly.